What is good, you guys? It's your boy Bolo, and I'm back again with another tutorial. And today's tutorial is something that you guys asked about, and of course, it's about Beat Maker 3.
Bolo!
So some of you guys have seen me make beats on Beat Maker 3, and of course, most of the time, well, just about all the time, I've used loop-based or sample-based samples to make beats on Beat Maker 3. So some of y'all were like, well, you know, what about VSTs in Beat Maker 3? What about using the keyboard in Beat Maker 3? Well, of course you can use a keyboard with Beat Maker 3, and Beat Maker 3 does have VSTs. Well, they're kind of VSTs, they call them audio units, but they're VSTs. At the end of the day, they sound great, and some of these VSTs you can get for like dirt cheap. So today I'm gonna make me a quick and simple beat using these audio units to make of course a trap style beat. Come on now, pretty much that's all I do. Let's go ahead, let's make a quick and simple beat, and let's see how it turns out. And one more thing before we do the tutorial, make sure you hit that subscribe button, make sure you hit that like button, please comment and turn on those post notifications so you will know when I have another video. Let's just go ahead and get to the tutorial right now. Okay, as you can see, I have my iPad right here and I have my MPK 25, old trusty. And I have it hooked into the special piece that goes inside of the, a USB piece. You can get off of Amazon. It plugs right inside of your iPad. Some of y'all might have a USB-C. I have the Lightning because I haven't upgraded mine yet, but just have it going through. And it's basically like a plug and play type of a deal. It works as soon as you plug it in. You might have to go into the settings in BeatMaker, but I don't remember if I did have to go into any settings, but it worked for me. So let's open up BeatMaker. And as you can see, it's gonna load up a new project. If you did have any problems with your keyboard, you can just go right here. And then what you could do is you can just go into audio and MIDI devices, make sure everything is clicked on. As you can see, it's showing my input and output devices and settings and behavior. Basically, this is how everything looks on mine. So if you have any problems, this is how it looks. So let me see here, route to all, MIDI selected, pad on. Everything is just basic, I believe. So that's what it looks like. So what I want to do is I want to show you guys how to load up these audio units. First thing you want to do is you want to go right here to this little wave symbol right here, which takes you into the sampler. And as you can see, you can access sampling a sound, which we've done that before, or we can load up audio units. So here we go. So we have three things. We have audio units, we have inter-app audios, and we have audio bus. The way this thing is routed now, we really don't have to use the audio bus, but some people still do. There's some inter-app audio that some apps haven't really caught up yet with it, but I use nothing but audio units because basically they're VSTs. So let's open it up and let's pick an audio unit to make a beat out of. One of my favorites is the SynthMaster 1. Gonna load that up, and there it is, SynthMaster 1, and I can play the keys. I can play those keys, or I can play it on here. So basically, that's how it works. So let's just go ahead and make a quick trap beat, and let's just see how it sounds. So I'm just gonna do this off the dome. I'm not gonna take a long time doing it. So let's go ahead and just pick some sounds. Let's go in the browser. Always do good with a bell. Let's pick a bell. Track first, let's do this. Let's make this 8 bars. Let's do the tempo at 135, we'll be fine with that. And quantize at 16. And let's make a track. okay, added a sound. Let's go ahead and add another sound and just layer that with something else. And I'm probably going to use like two sounds on this one because this is just for a tutorial. So let's just load up a sound in here. This one's pretty cool. Presets in here. Let's go with a lead. Let's do like a lead. That sounds pretty good. Something real basic. Let's go ahead and add some drums to it and just call it a day. It's gonna be something real quick and simple, but you see pretty much how the process is. So let's go ahead and add some claps, some hats, and some bass. And might add a kick, we'll see. Quick and simple beat using BeatMaker 3 with an actual MIDI keyboard. Hope you guys enjoyed it. And let me go ahead and play the beat so you can hear how I patterned everything out and see how it sounds. So let's check it out right now.